This is Blender, open source 3D software that can be used to make animations, visual effects, game assets, or practically anything 3D. And best of all, it's 100% free and it always will be. If you've never used it before but you want to learn it, well, then you're in the right place.
Whoa, that's a cool intro you got there, but we kind of need to go to the video now. So, now it's just me. That's crazy. But anyways, today I'm going to be making donuts in four different apps or softwares or whatever you want to call it. It's specifically four because some guy on the street told me that if I were to do five, my house would explode.
Okay, here we are in Windows Paint 3D. Yes, that exists. And luckily, there was a shape right there. Donut. If you can't read that, I'm not sure how that will turn out in the video, but there's a donut. So I placed down the donut. Well, a little thin there. And yeah, that's already a pretty good donut right there. I managed to do that within like 5 seconds. So I color the donut, then I copy it to make the frosting, which will be pink. However, it's still looking a little bit bland, and so time to add sprinkles. It was actually a bit harder to add sprinkles than you would think it would be, and definitely does not look as good as Blender, but hey, at least we have that guy right there, you know, the little blue guy, or I actually changed him to be green. And after some finishing touches, we have already finished our Paint 3D donut in less than 5 minutes. So I hopped onto Unity, which was actually my first time creating a 3D Unity project. I looked around, and then I created an object that looked the most similar to a donut, which happened to be a cylinder. And so I placed that in the scene there. Yep, there you go. And then I scaled it to, you know, actually be like the size of a donut, to look more like a donut. Yep, there you go. And then I created a duplicate of it for the frosting. Idled it frosting, of course. Moved it up. And I think that looks pretty good. Move the camera around. And bam. There you go. That's your Unity donut right there. Let's move on, actually. So the next one is CapCut. So I hopped on CapCut. And I got some donut images because, yes, I'm making a donut edit now. You can't stop me. We're doing it, and we're just gonna hope it turns out good, okay? So, I got a lot of images from Petzels, and then I put them in there. I edited them, and I'm not too sure what else to say. As you can see there, it's very sped up. That's like 40 times speed, by the way. It was like 21 minutes of just me editing the video, but I realized that I needed more videos because it was kind of short, and so I went to Mitskit and then got some more donut videos after that. You can see there, and then we go back, put the videos in there, we do more editing, and then in the end, we get this. Okay, that actually turned out way better than I thought it would, so let's head on to our final software that we're making a donut in. You've been waiting for it, Blender. Okay, so the main reason I made this video was actually because I was learning how to make a donut in Blender. However, I came up with the video idea after I began doing that, so obviously I don't have the recording for me making the donut. And the donut you see in the background here is actually me recreating one quickly just to show you what it would be like. So, I think I should show you my actual donut in 3, 2, 1. And there you go. That's the final donut there that I made in Blender. Note, I haven't actually finished the donut tutorial yet, but it definitely does look better than the Paint 3D one, and the Unity one, and probably the CapCut one too. Anyways, that's all I have to really say here. If you want to watch another video, click on one of these. If you want to subscribe, click on the little channel icon, and have a nice day.